Hello everyone, welcome you all in my new video. In this video I am going to solve a problem which is based on Darcilla. So this is the third video which is related to groundwater geology. So the question is, an inclined cylinder confined aquifer has coefficient of permeability of 40 meter per day. So the given that, first we will write what is given. So the given physical quantity, that is coefficient of permeability, which is represented by K, and the value is 40 meter per day. Next, the horizontal distance between two vertical wells penetrating the aquifer is 800 meter. So the horizontal distance between two wells, which is represented by del L, and the value is 800 meter. So next is the water surface elevation in the well are 50 meter and 45 meter. So the water elevation is H1, which is 50 meter, and H2, which is 45 meter above a common horizontal datum. So in the figure you can see this is the datum. Next is the absolute value of Darcy flux through the aquifer is. So we have to find the value of Darcy flux. So now moving towards the figure. So this is the, you can say, the experimental arrangement of Darcy law. So basically Darcy law is state that this is the flow through a porous medium, that is flow of fluid, which is described by Darcy law in a porous medium. So in the figure, if we consider, this is the cross-sectional area of a cylinder, and the water is flowing in this direction at the rate of Q. So here Q, we can say rate of flow which is going inside the cylinder, and the cylinder is filled with sand and piezometer. So cylinder is filled with sand and piezometer, and the piezometer is a device which is used to measure the liquid pressure in a system by measuring the height to which a column of liquid rises against the gravity. So here this is one, this is second, this is the piezometer, and the distance between these two piezometer is del L. So this is the piezometer, and you can see this is the height, that is water level of two piezometer, and del H is the difference between that. So del H is the difference between two height. Next is, so inflow is Q, and the same rate the water will flow outside, that is Q, which will be outflow rate. So the rate will be same. Next, so the Darcy found that the flow rate, which is, so here flow rate is Q, which is proportional to the cross section area of the cylinder, that is this one area, this area, which is cross section area, which is represented by A. So the Q is proportional to A. So Q is proportional to A. Next, the piezometer height difference, that is, so the piezometer height difference is del S, that is the water level difference of two piezometers. So that will, Q is also proportional to del H, or we can say H2 minus H1 or H1 minus H2. So this is the proportional to the piezometer height difference. Next is, it is inversely proportional to the distance between piezometer. So this is the second. Next is Q, which is proportional to the difference between horizontal distance between two piezometer. So which is inversely proportional, not directly proportional. So Q, which is equals to, sorry, which is proportional to 1 over del L. So third, this is the third parameter. So if we combined these three equation, that is equation first, equation second, and equation third, if we combine these three, we will get Q, which is equals to minus K A del H by del L. So this is the Darcy equation, where K is proportionality constant. And which is known as hydraulic head. So this is known as hydraulic head. This is known as hydraulic conductivity. So this is known as hydraulic conductivity, not hydraulic head. So this is the Darcy equation. Next physical quantity is specific discharge, which is represented by Q and defined as the per unit area flow through the cylinder. So Q, which is equals to capital Q divided by A. So this is the flow rate and this is the area. So that will represent per unit area flow through the cylinder. So this is the quantity which is known as specific discharge, or represented by Q. So from equation 1 and equation 2, so Q, which is equals, sorry, small q, which is equals to K A del H by del L and divided by A. So that will be equals to K del H by del L. So this is the value in terms of del H and del L. So this value, that is Q, which is also known as Darcy velocity, or we can say Darcy flux. Here the dimension of Q, which is equals to meter cube, that is L3 divided by time. So this is the unit, that is dimension of Q discharge. So dimension of specific discharge will be, that is Q, the dimension will be L divided by T. So this is the dimension of velocity, so which is also known as Darcy velocity. So now moving towards the problem. So we have to find the value of Darcy flux. So Darcy flux, which is defined as Q, which is equals to K into del H divided by del L. So del H will be 5, del L will be 800, and K which is 40. So by putting all the values, Q will be 40 into 5 divided by 800. Q will be 200 divided by 800, which is equals to 1/4, that is 0.2. So the Darcy flux will be 0.25. So the answer will be 0.25.